team back. Remaining. Reserve time.
No.
Dire team back. Radiant team back.
Alchemist.
Team pick. Radiant team pick. Ten seconds remaining.
Are we live? Oh. Hi, Charlie. How are you feeling?
Good.
Are you excited?
Yeah. To see Shazam play? I haven't seen much of them so far. I've been casting the other side of the bracket, so... Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm excited. I'm excited, man.
All right.
Excited to be
here. Is your mic a little
here.
Close? Everyone wants to hear you, Charlie.
Okay, we're getting
good?
In the draft.
We good?
We're good. Game one, Shazam versus Kingdom Dota.
I'm not on camera anymore, right? Okay.
All right, here we go. So we got the Alchemist pick. That hero's been winning a lot of games.
He's great. Just,
you put a mid, and it's like one of those heroes where the other team feels like you have to do something about it. Almost like, you know, the AM time bomb? Like, so many patches ago when AM was, like, really good? I feel like that's sort of like Alchemist now.
Yeah, except if you kill him, he still gets, like...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You get, like, he farms faster than he dies
mm-hmm.
in most circumstances.
Mm-hmm. But you feel like you have to address it.
Or pick AA.
Yeah.
And they will not
we haven't seen that.
Sometimes we do.
Yeah, but we haven't seen that very much.
No.
Especially during the...
Yeah, we'll fight them with more farm.
Yeah,
we'll
that'll
scout
work.
Him out
that'll
with
work.
Hawk.
That'll work. Well, AA wouldn't actually be that bad here. You have setup stuns for it. It's great against the Alchemist, great against the Enchantress as well.
10 seconds remaining. I'm... pretty sure it'll be banned out. I would hope it would be banned.
Yeah, if I were Shazam, I'd ban it out right now.
Kingdom Dota, going for the physical right-click strategy.
So the Vision Strat?
So the Vision Strat.
I do like Slaughter Beastmaster.
Solid opener.
Mm-hmm. Let's see if they ban out the AA here.
Okay, they have banned out the Winter Wyvern. Plague to single
target
right-click. As well as push.
Mm-hmm.
Which is also what Beastmaster is good at. He's just very good versus Beastmaster in general.
Yeah, a lot of teams have liked him a lot this patch. I think he's pretty good.
Good job, Ja. 5 seconds. Okay. Want to talk about these two teams? Who's Jason?
Jason is... What do you mean Jason? Jason is Jason.
Jason's just Jason?
Yeah.
Okay. I know a few Jasons, though.
So. Oh, yeah. I think there are two.
There are two?
Yeah.
He's just normal Jason?
Yeah, he's Jason.
Okay.
I don't know him by another name, so he's just Jason.
Alright. I know everyone else in this game.
Yeah.
We got some Leviathan players, we have Zizzy of former Complexity, 747 of Oriole, and Ja.
And like five other teams.
Yeah, that's true.
And then Newsham Jenkins from Leviathan, Ja was their coach. And 747 is also known as Susie, if you guys... didn't know him by 747. And then they're in a team house.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah,
they talked to Ja about it.
Yeah,
he said it
camping.
Was supposed to be like under wraps. Or
under wraps?
I was like, I mean, is anyone really scouting out Kingdom?
Does anyone care that much?
No. Well, it's because I was like chilling with him and playing pubs and I was on stream. He's like, oh, wait, I wasn't supposed to say that we have a team house. I'm like,
who cares, dude? They also,
yeah.
Like, I'm pretty sure they've, like, they... the team house, they got a dog for the team house, and they posted pictures of it, so I don't know.
This was like a month and a half ago.
Oh, okay.
Maybe it was like before it was announced.
Yeah, who cares?
I'm with you, Charlie.
Who cares?
I care about the dog.
I do care about the dog.
What kind of dog is it?
I don't know. It's like a cute little puppy thing.
So can we Google Kingdom Dota team house dog?
I think so. Webboss.
I'll Google it.
Alright. And then on the other side, we have Shazam. I think most people would consider these guys the favorite of not only this group, but the American Regional Qualifier as a whole.
Okay, my first page Google search didn't work.
Alright.
Yeah, they are very good.
Yeah, we got Brax and MSS of old Cloud9 slash, and then MSS from teams like EG, DC. Mouse.
Wait, was he on DC? I don't
know. MSS was not on DC. MSS is the DC Slayer. MSS has a history going all the way back to Narvi of knocking out, like, overpaid North American teams.
So is that going to be this time too? Or does DC fall into that category now?
I'll put American in quotations, but
okay, but they're overpaid. I didn't hear you contest that point, Charlie.
I mean, we'll see. This will be the qualifier to really test DC, right? Can they earn their keep? Can they make it into a Valve event?
So Invoker, also another single target physical damage hero, as well as tons of magical.
Shazam did ban out the AA.
Good job. And then Winter Wyvern, Tidehunter. Actually, Shazam's teamfight is terrible.
Dude, it's only two hero picks in.
I know, I'm just saying, like, they banned out the other teamfighter heroes, too. I'm just saying. Yeah. With Alchemist, though, he's a teamfighter. I was talking to Mott. He's like a core. He can make your other heroes a core. He's like 3.5 cores himself.
Yeah, yeah.
He's a teamfighter.
He's everything. You just run in with the Radiance, and everyone takes a bunch of burn damage. Yeah, that guy does everything. He's got a stun. He's like super fast as well.
Solo Roche, do Ancients,
mm-hmm.
Push Towers.
River Team Eggs.
Get Runes.
Support. All of it.
Yeah. He's great.
Minus Armor. What a hero, man.
AoE stun.
He does have an AoE stun. So we got the Venge. This is more Minus Armor. Minus armor single target from Kingdom Dota.
Push him down.
Oh, there you go. There's your team fight. The MSS. No, that'll be the Brax Darkseer.
This is like a DC strat. This is very similar to what we saw them run. Alchemist plus Darkseer, although it was on Radiant.
I mean, I think that's just it's pretty good overall.
I'm just saying it's. If you are on Dire, I would say like it's a little bit easier because you can contest Roche with a team fight. With Radiant, it's like, well, they can just do Roche and you can't really go into there if you don't have early
control. This is interesting.
Muffling. Make Illusions of Alchemist. Have your own Pocket Alchemist.
Pocket Alchemist.
Yeah.
No, I'm...
It's not that great versus Ench, though. You can't really...
No, it's... I mean, you... If you could burst her down if you go, you know, the F-Blade route.
Yeah. So they have some variable damage, which is good. Also, more physical right-click.
Yeah.
If you need
it. I mean, it's still a lot of single-target DPS. There's not a lot of teamfight here out of Kingdom Dota.
No ways to really stop the Darkseer, too, it seems. Like, if they initiate on someone, I could easily see Darkseer just owning them with Vacuum Wall.
Mm-hmm.
Lion, very good versus Morphling.
It's a very popular support overall. It does so many things.
But
it's
if good. He gets jumped, he's just dead instantly in his lineup.
He's a. I find most teams that pick Lion, your Lion is either Ownage or he just dies first every single team fight.
You wish he were Revenge.
Yeah. Very feast or famine. All right, and we have the last pick here. Shazam needs, I guess, a safe lane carry. And Kingdom needs maybe another support. Depending.
Could be mid.
Yeah, maybe a mid. Could be Morphling mid. I don't know.
Morphling has high armor. He could potentially deal with Alchemist.
I mean, we don't see him very often at all. Maybe this is their way of dealing with Alchemist. Morphling. I don't know if that's very good or not, but.
It doesn't sound that good in theory. What are good counters to Morphling? Let's see what Dota Buff has for us.
Really?
For Alchemist.
Oh,
yo,
oh.
Yo, it has great stuff about
it. Alright, alright, let's see this.
Okay.
Alchemist.
Number one, Worst versus Viper.
Viper, Io, and Meepo.
Meepo I can see, for sure. Because he can always catch him out split pushing as well as push out all the lanes and kill him.
Yeah.
Io, I'm not sure about.
Viper's interesting.
Viper's amazing versus him. And AA is actually nowhere on here.
I don't think... I mean, Dota buffs pub stats, right?
Yeah.
You don't see a lot of AA
but still, you see some unusual matchups. Like, you would never suspect Viper is good versus Alk, but maybe...
I mean, apparently Troll is good against Alk, according to Dota buff.
Troll's just amazing. I'm on board with that hero.
What?
It's just ideas, Charlie. You can shoot him down. I'm okay with that.
Chardeep's not a fan.
Don't give me stats.
Don't give me
no
stats.
Numbers.
Chardeep doesn't have time for numbers, man.
Prophet ban.
Okay, so they...
More...
I like Death Prophet against Alchemist.
Seems alright, but... Like, Death Prophet just farms so much slower than Alk.
Yeah, if you don't take... You can still pressure the lane.
If you're behind at like 10 minutes, you just feel like you just lose. Like, your first 6 minutes are fine.
That's true for a lot of heroes as well. I feel like you have to do something against the Alchemist here. You can't just let him get bounty rooms, farm like a sub 10 minute armlet.
Nice.
Huh. You know, a lot of teams have secretly been a fan of Chaos Knight.
He's like an armlet hero.
He is an armlet hero. The more armlet heroes you have. But yeah, a lot of... I've talked to a lot of players and... They secretly say, you know, Chaos Knight is really OP.
He is.
He's
great
our
for
hero.
Single target physical.
Yeah.
Because they don't have enough AoE.
They have no AoE. They virtually have no AoE here.
Now they have Earth Spirit.
They still, you know, Kingdom still doesn't have very much teamfight. They barely have any wave clear.
They have wave.
I hate you.
Boulder smash into waveform. With axes. With Wave of Terror. Terrible.
I think unless Kingdom snowballs really, really hard in the mid game, Shazam should take this. Ignoring like player skill and stuff like that. I think just draft wise I like Shazam's a lot better.
I do too. I would like this a lot more if Kingdom were on Dire.
Yeah. They have the minus armor for Rosh, but I mean even then, their team fight is just
Shazam's teamfight's not that great.
They have a Darkseer. They have an Alchemist. They have a Chaos Knight.
Okay,
against, no AoE.
Minimal AoE.
Okay.
He can replicate the Alchemist for more AoE.
Okay, I'm stretching it.
Okay, we are in the game, ladies and gentlemen. There is lag, and I will introduce the teams. On the side of Radiant, we have Kingdom, Ja, taking up the reins as a vengeful spirit, 747, aka Susie. On the Slardar, Ziz, aka Zizzy. On the Morphling, Nushim taking up the Earth Spirit, and Jenkins rounding it out on the Beastmaster. And on the Dire side, Charlie?
We have Brax on the Darkseer. We have Jason on the Lion, MSS on that mid Alchemist, Savage on the Enchantress, and top Canadian TC on that Chaos Knight.
I have not seen some of these cosmetics.
Dude, the Chaos Knight cosmetics are sick.
Yeah, what does he have? I just never see this hero anymore.
I dislike that helmet, though.
Yeah, I don't like the helmet. It makes him look strange.
He looks like a 5-year-old drew that helmet.
You know, I do you know the Lone Druid set? That is terrible looking. There's one of them that's just like, what is going on with his Lone Druid set? Anyways, there's one Lone Druid set that doesn't look that great. And
okay.
I was like shifting through my cosmetics while I was streaming. I was like, wow, this set looks awful. And then the person who made it was in my chat. It was a little awkward. But yeah, well, it doesn't look great. At least I'm honest, right?
Yeah.
Would you prefer me lie about it? If you were a workshop artist and your set was on display on stream, would you prefer me to lie about it or say it was terrible?
That depends. How many people were you streaming to?
It was a couple thousand.
Lie about it, dude.
But what if it's just like glaringly obvious that it's terrible? Like the CK helmet.
You know what? The ideal scenario is for you to be like, oh my god, this looks ridiculous. I want to wear it.
That's the case with Sven Pantaloons.
What?
Have you seen the Sven Pantaloons?
No.
They look like jester pants. They're like striped and
stuff. I mean, there are some ridiculous things that never should have made it into the game. One being the Crystal Maiden IX Mike stash. I'm sorry.
I agree with this. Okay, Shazam eyeing to look for a bounty rune, but they don't really have any eyes on Kingdom, so not sure where they're committing to just yet. MSS surely wants that Grievous Greed. And it looks like they will be top. And they drop a ward for it. But both teams level 1 is not terribly great, so they are not making any aggressive maneuvers.
Shazam does have the Darkseer on show.
Jenkins, looking to contest the bounty.
And MSS will get that bounty rune.
300 gold in the bank.
He's rich.
He is rich. Alchemist Helm is also not that great.
You know, there are some players that purposely just pick the ugliest stuff.
It's distracting sometimes, which is great for your team.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm glad we had to talk about cosmetics, Charlie.
Yeah, me
too. SVG rounding out the bend, trying to snipe a courier. Shazam onto his wily tricks.
We'll send it all the way around.
Mass Bay, Lord of Tempest.
Oh, MSS.
Oh my god,
getting gone.
That is a lot of right click. Yeah. Oh, that miss. Whew, that was tough. Well,
if he didn't up, he'll miss. He should have died there.
Yeah. Well, he does have boots right now, but no salve. And the chicken is still at the T2. Going in for the second roll. Nushim way off the mark there. Still a lot of pressure coming MSS's way. He has 300 gold, but not too much coming in after that.
Yeah, it will be a mid-morphling after all.
I guess he's good with the ES. Oh, and another roll! Nushim! Looks like they will be able to get the first blood over to here. Ziz, not even level 2. Two rolls connected. Well played by Nushim. A lot of gold. It's like 600 gold.
Yeah.
Not really. Oh, 400 gold!
Oh, that's actually pretty significant.
That is. Blood.
Yeah, MSS can't be happy about that.
And
oh!
I don't...
Pot.
Creeps up the hill.
Yeah. So he won't see this. It'll be a rude surprise when
he gets
when the
game explode.
He gets unpaused. What level is the morphling now?
Level 2.
Okay, so he has a waveform now.
Okay, let's see the roll. It will connect. Will there be a waveform?
Oh, and there's a pushback.
God. How is Nushim level 2 already? Well, MSS desperately trying to run for his life, and he does not have any regen. Chicken is far away. This will hurt his farm a lot. Zizzy, he is low on HP, but at least he has his bottle. And Shared Tank goes off cooldown. This is rough. MSS not leading the good life. Unless he gets a bounty rune over here, this could make up for his prior errors. Bam. Plus 162.
Does he have a self faring out to him right now?
He should.
He does, alright.
Well played.
And you know, the real sad thing is that he's still going to get a lot of farm.
That is what Alchemist does. He has 7 CS. It's actually pretty good, considering the situation. As a spray.
And every bounty room he picks up just makes up for it. Makes up for every death.
Yeah. You're lazy. You're not even doing your own camera.
I got Whip-Us, man.
You do have Whip-Us.
I don't wanna touch any of this technology stuff.
Oh man, that's a two seconder coming out from TC. And looks like he was dead regardless of the duration of that stun. Played.
That's good rotation.
He's keeping Beastmaster level 1. Good thing he has Iron Talon.
To the jungle. Ha ha ha.
I can tell you're not a big fan of the Iron Talon.
No, man.
You like my 6 being punished?
Yeah.
You don't like out getting bounty rune and just making up for it as one death and
no, I like skill being involved in this game and roll again, but MSS not gonna get hit this time.
You like skill being involved.
Yeah, man. Whatever skill I may, you know, lack or whatever, I still like it being rewarded.
I see. Brax getting good amounts of XP on bottom, no Quelling Blade or signs of a jungling build from him quite yet. Trying to deal with Ja, running him out constantly. And 747's getting pretty good farm despite the double Ion Shell. This is one of the downsides of having a Slaughter in this lineup. Not the best hero versus the Darkseer, but you have Avenge on dedicated duty to be all good. And first tower shortly falling.
He's got a lot of denies against the Darkseer as well.
Denies mean more now. Are you happy about that? Because range?
I am happy about that. Makes lane control more important.
What's your least favorite change in the past few months?
12 teams being invited to the Vanilla Major.
We went there. We went there.
Yep. Chardeep thinks that's a bad philosophy.
Not you, Chardeep. Soul Ring on Alk. We've seen a lot of different Alk builds. Some get bottle, some get casual Sage Mask. Yes, Soul Ring. When you're Struggle City, seems like Soul Ring's pretty good.
No,
or if you're taking a lot of stacks.
Yeah, Soul Ring's good. Unless you just, you know, not have to deal with
mana issues
or really getting harassed in the lane. You can just go to the jungle. Get easy.
But I thought you're not supposed to like that.
Yeah, I mean, I don't like it, but if you gotta do it, you know, it's good.
And Brax off to the jungle?
I don't want to see this PvE stuff, you know?
There's a lot of PvE going on right now.
There's been a lot of PvE in Dota in the last, you know, however many patches.
Would you prefer, like, the Magnus AM era?
No, I prefer the... Remember when Blink Dagger wasn't disabled when you got hit?
Oh, that was, like, 7 years ago, man.
Yeah, that was so much fun. So much fun.
Felt like Dota Imba. Oh! Let's see what TC's building. Looks like it will be Armlet first. You know, CK got stronger too because of the mana pool buff.
Yeah.
He
used to have mana problems and now...
And
well, looks like he's dead.
He has a lot of problems. Unless he can Reality Rift and do a sick play right here. Nope.
I think it was pretty greedy farming. Going out that far to farm.
Gotta respect the boulder.
And there are like three heroes off the map. He should know they just go to the jungle
at
that point.
Okay, he spent his gold. He knows Brax is... Oh my goodness, that was so much
also dead.
Damage.
Well, Morphling has a DD.
Yeah, that was...
DD
insane.
Plus amp. Brax isn't that high of a level either.
Any team of wards on the map?
Oh my god!
Nushim is... doing really
Kingdom,
well.
Kingdom, Dota, who are you?
It's all the ES.
Yeah, this... doing work.
He is.
He... gank top. Immediately goes mid. Just
a sign of a good player.
No, I mean it's just like great rotations. He's like looking for.
He's efficient.
Very efficient. He's looking for stuff to happen.
Feels like Shazam's actually scared of the ES way more than Kingdom's scared of the Alk. They should be. That's good.
I mean, you know at this point Alk isn't going to get that active. He had a rough time mid, so he just needs to catch up now.
And do jungle stacks.
Yeah. And he doesn't have any levels of concoction. He's not going to really do anything. And this is... I like that Kingdom recognizes this is their window to punish Shazam. This is what their lineup is good at. You have the Earth Spirit, you have the Venge, you have the Beastmaster. It's time to get pickoffs. It's time to get map control.
Dengen's still looking to get level 6 in this top lane. TC playing it safe at the tower. No supports behind him.
They do have a ward spotting out, though. But yep. He should see... Does he see that Hawk?
I don't think so. My time's tough.
No. The TC should just get back. He's just running back and forth. At that point, he should just know. You know, cut your losses.
Not if you can armlet toggle.
Alright, let's hope
faith.
He gets...
He has faith in the armlet toggle.
He needs some support here. Some TPs, if they go on him. He should be telling his team right now, hey...
Actually, it's a nice play by him waiting for daytime. Time yeah. Makes it a lot safer for him. Much more difficult to gank, and
well,
they
he
have to sense something is up.
He should definitely go back now because he should be able to see that the rest of his team is moving to make a play on bottom. So they're not going to be able to TP top for him. He should just get off the map. Great sense by top Canadian. TP's bottom to join the gank.
747. What are you going to buy with your 2700? Is it going to be an armlet or is it going to be a blink?
You better buy it quick, dude, because you're dead.
And not the same game sense as Top Canadian. He will buy his blink dagger, but it looks like it's going to be a chain feed, possibly on the bottom lane. Earth Spirit rolling out of there. Shazam TC desperately hot on his tracks.
Oh,
with
Top
surge.
Canadian.
And the surge will track down the pesky Earth Spirit. But it looks like they are trying to get real active with the Sword Art blink, although it is a naked blink. No treads to his name.
And this is the problem with these kind of lineups against the Alchemist. If you can't do well for just the first 6, 7, 8 minutes, you have to really keep that momentum up, and then when you fall behind, or when that momentum stops and you feed two big kills like that, all of a sudden, you know, the Alchemist is caught back up. Gold graph is not in your favor anymore, and you know, a lot of your momentum is gone. This lineup doesn't leave that much room for mistakes.
It doesn't. Alchemist does not, but Kingdom know that. Three man smoke up to the dire jungle. Who will they find? They see Jason, not interested at all. Alchemist does have his armlet popped as well as the ultimate. Can they get the kill? See a double stun. And they do not have enough damage. Is he going to be able to armlet toggle through it?
He's dead.
Oh, nice time stun by Nushim. I like how he was super patient, knowing that the only way he gets out is through the armlet toggle. Well played. Well played, sir.
They did have enough lockdown to get him, and they did have that ward scouting him out in the dire jungle. So good play by Kingdom, keeping up the aggression, not getting discouraged by that chain feed bottom.
It was only two kills. TC with the DD. 747 does have his blink, just toying with him. This is one of the problems with CK. He has awful versus blink.
He just has awful cast animation.
Yep.
On everything.
And travel time on Chaos Bolt and Wind Up.
Yeah.
And it's super obvious. It makes this very loud noise when you're reality drifting. It's not subtle.
I mean, you can do the cute animation cancel thing with Blink Strike, but that doesn't have very many practical purposes.
Annoy your enemies?
It is very annoying.
Jenkins, maybe looking for a solo kill in the top lane, and his ward will be dewarded. Jason,
new ward
spot. Pretty happy about that. New ward spot.
Very cute. New-ish.
Snap and Spyfly. Cool name.
You know, speaking of cosmetics while we're looking at these things, I really like Kingdom's Courier.
Which one is this?
This.
Oh, the Mask Fey Lord of Tempest? Where is this from anyways?
I don't know. Look at that thing. That's awesome.
This thing is pretty sick.
Yo, that's sick, man. Something out of a Ghibli movie.
Isn't your birthday coming up soon?
No.
No? Okay. I was saying someone should maybe get you a courier.
No, I'm not,
I confuse you with the other Asian. Will's birthday is pretty soon.
That's like racist.
It is.
Ming Li?
I hate you.
Hey, you brought it up, man.
Jenkins, looking for Brax in the back. He is hiding in the trees. Brax, will he run up? They will get spotted out by the Hawk, and the team is hot on his trails. A boulder in. Brax, Chain Sun, Silence, 7-7, in with the amp. That is a good kill by Jenkins. Nice patient waiting. Of course, they did have the Observer Ward in the back. If there were any supports coming in, and Brax is probably wondering, wow, how did they know I was there?
You should have known that they spotted him, because that ward has been up there for a while, and TC definitely knew that there was a ward up there.
He played like there was.
Yeah. But he most likely did.
Most likely.
Anyways, he should know that entire side of the map is unsafe.
Yep, these two teams are really good about spending their gold before they die, though. I will give credit to both teams for that. Earth Spirit, no arcanes, no treads. He will be going for the buckler first. Plus armor is good versus
getting the mech
dire.
Eventually into the Greaves. That armor is going to be good against, you know, the CK, the Elk. You want to do a Tome of Knowledge check?
Oh, yes. Okay, it has been bought by Dire side. Radiant side has also been bought. These two teams know what's up. And we see a replicate of the Enchantress immediately stolen by SVG.
What a player. What a player that guy is.
Not a useful spell versus enchant. It will help her farm and get her cleft. Lost the wolf. Oh, got a passive game on our hands. Morphling with a super farming Midas bots, looking to challenge Alchemist as king of net worth.
Yeah.
But Alchemist is still king.
And he's gonna get richer even sooner as he gets really close to that Radiance.
And the Ancient Stack coming up very soon. Swap into a stun. They spot two TPs out and immediately back off.
What does Brax have right now? Okay, is he going Midas, or is he going Mechanism as well?
What okay. do you mean?
Oh, never mind.
Did you think that ES and Ant were on the same team?
No. I thought I saw somebody else on Shazam getting.
Oh. Nah. Radiance online. MMSS.
Do you feel like this is kind of a slow mech timing? Out of the Dark Seer
definitely.
As well. Yeah.
He got pressured really hard by the Ventral Spirit, and then Jenkins that really nice gank on the top lane to slow him down significantly. And his jungle's constantly occupied by the Ench plus the Alk. I don't blame him for it.
Fair.
It looks slow, but there are reasons for it. And their jungle's not safe. Or so they feel.
Yeah, there's two Radiant Wards in their jungle, in addition to that Hawk.
I feel like TC's very poor.
I mean, they're all sort of poor except for the Alchemist. And even then, this is like not the ideal Alchemist game either. He got pressured mid, the rest of his team is getting pressured, they're not really creating that much space for him. As the bottom tier 1 for Dire will fall.
Seems like Shazam's kind of getting, they can't farm the jungle safely. Like, their own jungle is warded, this bottom T1's getting taken down, so now they have access to the Ancient Stack, which they probably haven't scouted out yet, but I mean, Zizzy's farming out pretty deep, going in for a kill on Brax. Brax,
he won't get the kill.
Heavy. It's still pressure. Shazam, SVG, and Jason smoked up near top rune. Who are they going to find? Oh, Kingdom with a counter smoke. Four people trying to maybe wrap around TC. Is the support going to get there on time? They scan. They will not see the heroes that smoke. TC uses his ultimate and will get roared and stunned up. Will he be able to armlet toggle? No. And that scan was actually perfect timing. I don't actually know what they would have done had they seen the scan, but still had the right idea. Jason trying to help his old boy TC. We'll give another kill.
Just space for Alchemist.
Not good. That's not the good type of space.
No, it's definitely not the good type of space. But my worry for Kingdom is that eventually in...
The Morphling's getting big, though.
He is. But in like 10 minutes, they don't have the greatest way of breaking high ground as well.
They don't need to break high ground. They have Morphling.
They also don't have the greatest team fight. My worry is that they're going to try and break high ground, and then they're going to get vacuum walled. Well,
I don't even know if they're interested in breaking high ground, because he went Midas bots. Midas bots is like, I don't want to touch high ground for 40 minutes.
Yeah, fair.
I think they want to do Roche, and they steal the Ancients. Now you're actually worried for Shazam. This is the bad type of space.
At this point, now I'm worried, because that Ancient Stack was Alchemist's way of really pulling ahead in this game, and now...
Well, Shazam actually trying to maybe get some kills. SVG hiding in the Roche pit. Brax coming around from the backside. See a blink out from Slaughter Arja, desperately trying to get what gold he can before he gets taken down by Lion.
Not going to get the Ancient Black Dragon.
He really wanted that. 18 HP. Jason, is he even going to steal it? No, he's going to save it. Trusty MSS.
What a teammate.
What a teammate. Maybe he'll attack it when he wants to pull.
Accidentally take it?
He doesn't even take it. What? Oh, he didn't even stack it. Oh, man. He's not a teammate.
Going for the D ward.
Stack's more important. Stack is priority.
Yeah,
he has a tango,
dude. It does.
Eat it. Go for the stack. Efficiency.
Yeah, that was not value.
They gotta play the efficiency game at this point, because I know who is. Old Zizzy and the Morphling. Getting there, man.
Mm-hmm.
Getting big. They have a mech, but do they even want a team fight? Can they even team fight at this point?
Yeah, I think they can. I think they're far enough ahead that they can, depending on how that team fight goes.
I think their mentality is, though, we just need to get more farm. I don't think their mentality is...
I think their mentality should be, let's not take the risk and try and go for a fight. Pickoffs are still working for us. We have map control. We have vision. We should just keep on going for pickoffs.
Oh, there is a four-man smoke. It was scouted out by the trusty Hawk.
And he knows, and he's just going to get out of here.
Is he going to try and bait it out in the TP? Or is he...
What's the point of waiting right now?
To bait it out, bro. You're like, oh crap, smoke pop. And then,
he knows.
Then you TP out. See? You create space. This is good space.
Okay, yeah, this is good space, but... It is a risk. If he had hit that, that impale or something...
He uses Iron Talon to get into a really weird spot in the trees that no good player would expect you to be, though. So it was fairly low risk,
reward, I would say. I'm okay with it.
Good space, bad space reminds me of good touch, bad touch. Did you ever watch that when you were in school?
What's good touch, bad touch?
It was like a sexual harassment.
This
video
sounds
when
dirty.
You were a little kid.
Okay, so yeah. Okay.
It's what they taught kids in elementary school.
Wait, what?
I don't know. I had to watch it when I was like, I don't know.
Is this a demonstration or
program? It was just a video. It's like a program. It's like, you know, we had a DARE program. It's like drug abuse resistance education. It was similar
good
to that.
Good touch, bad touch.
Good touch, bad touch. Yeah.
So it's like, you know, it's not okay. If this is a good touch and
yeah,
this
a hug is
a
okay.
Touch.
Exactly. Okay. I think someone needs to show Priest video though.
I mean, I don't think the priests are the one that need to see it. I think they have a very good idea of what a bad touch is.
So maybe they need to show more kids then.
Yeah, maybe.
I think it was a good program. I know what it is.
Apparently it stuck with you. You
it
remembered.
Did. It's very easy to remember. Good touch, bad touch. Good space, bad space.
All right.
We're trying to promote healthy habits here. Okay, another smoke coming out from Shazam. Four heroes, they do she Shazam, and another Hawk scout on the smoke. Jenkins is being a player this game. Nusham will still die, but it's just an Earth Spirit. This is
good space.
It's good space. FSS happily farming the Ancients. But he got a lot of them stolen. Yeah, I would not be happy if I were MSS. My Ancients got jacked, dude. They're not even in the gold lead.
No, it's not. But his net worth is still going up at a fairly steady
not
pace.
Not that great, though. Only 3,000 above the Morphling.
The Morphling should have his Lincolns
very
yes.
soon. Recipe and Ulti Orb on the way and 300 gold.
How's the item progression for everybody else on Shazam? Let's take a look.
I hit my F5 button. You can take a look, Charlie. I'm sure he hit his F5 button.
Yeah, Weapon's got it. Alright, so Brax does have his mech now. PC's got Armlet Midas. MSS is a couple components away from his Manta style. Everyone's playing for the late game. Two Midases on, two Midases on Shazam.
I like Kingdom's mid game a lot more though, because for a couple reasons. Firstly, Shazam used a lot of smokes. So Kingdom know that any move they have to make is usually going to be unsmoked, which is easily scattered out by a Hawk. Secondly, I think they have a better Roche lineup, especially given the map control that they have. So I think Roche will be a quick work, let's say, if they smoke gank the Ancients, kill one hero, do Roche.
I agree.
And on top of that, Morphling, he's not supposed to farm this fast. He's not a great farmer in the early game. Once he gets his split push items, sure. But we're talking about 22 minutes of game. He is very close to the net worth leader. 2,700 away, which is, I would say, very close to Alchemist. That's surprisingly close. And that is not good for Shazam. And Jenkins, with the Blink Dagger and Necro 3, almost gets the roar out on the Darkseer, but Brax did not poke his head out, and slowly but surely, Shazam losing map control. First the Hawk scouting at the smokes, now Necro 3 pushing down towers, taking down wards. They really don't have any vision. 747 going for the smoke. Will he catch anyone? No one is at the Ancients. They would love to take this down to get the Roche. But Shazam, very, very scared on this side of the map.
Their game plan right now should be establish map control around the pit, try and get a pickoff, and then go for Roche.
They are very close, but Shazam are actually collapsing around the pit too. Three heroes on the south side, two heroes on the north. Kingdom filing in from the mid lane. Enchanter's
Creed. If the game
Creed
is going to turn
vision.
Around for Shazam, it's going to be right here.
It is. And can they actually make a move? No smoke at the ready. Where is Darkseer? He is their teamfight initiator. They do have a smoke. Brax and Jason in the back. Blink Dagger on the ready for Darkseer. Shazam TC. Baiting heroes out. Oh, what a nice dodge with the Phantasm. Nuja looks like he's going to get broken down. Four heroes caught by the vacuum wall. 747 dies an Enchantress. Jenkins quickly dies thereafter. Brax with the huge plays there. 4-0. You called it. That
almost
is the comeback.
Full wipe.
That is almost a full wipe. They got destroyed by vacuum wall.
And that's the worry. If they ever try and take a team fight, even with their net worth lead, it wasn't that much. And the ability of the Darkseer to just turn around the team fight and control it versus the face of no AoE, what does Kingdom do? And I want to give props to Top Canadian.
Yeah, he was actually the playmaker right there.
Just dodge the crush straight up right there. He knew at that moment, this is the time. I have to do it right now or I'm dead.
And on top of that, they dodge the smoking. If one person were farming Ancients, they die, someone buys back, and a fight probably doesn't happen.
Yeah, it's great game sense out of Shazam.
Yeah, that was incredible by Shazam. And that pretty much secures next 10 minutes for them. They feel very comfortable right now after that just silly one fight. And you know, this is why you pick Darkseer. All you need to do is win one team fight. Alchemist is in the game.
Yes. Pardeep has seen this story before.
Well, Orphling still has his game plan B, going for the F-Blade shotgun. Looks like Enchantress.
But again,
really
it's more single target DPS.
Oh, is he going to enchant it? Okay. Well, there goes your ultimate, Zizzy. You can replicate to destroy it. I don't know about that one.
I mean,
maybe he wants to be cheeky. Jimmy would.
Jimmy absolutely would.
Jimmy would.
I mean, it's kind of worth it. It's a great farming tool for Enchantress. Radiant Alchemist.
Yep. Armlet not on, though.
Not value,
mega value. Yeah. Still value, though.
It's just good, not really good.
Dude, SVG is so farmed. How is his edge so farmed?
Get a Midas.
Yeah, he is ridiculously farmed.
And you know what? While the rest of his cores were getting caught by ganks, he wasn't.
He actually does a lot more late game than the Darkseer. Mm-hmm. So that's actually pretty smart by Shazam.
I mean, really, the Darkseer doesn't need that much this game. Just Dagger, Greaves, and...
As long as he makes that play, that's all you need.
But really, that's all he really needs to make that play.
Yep. So nice BKB.
Yeah. I guess if he gets scouted out, maybe he gets, like, Wave of Terror or something.
Yeah. I think, like, potentially he might be a good swap target later, right? They might, like, shoot a boulder and then swap into the sun and they just kill
him. I think my target of choice, if I'm Kingdom, every single fight, yeah, you have to get the Darkseer out because you have no other way of really countering Vacuum Wall.
Five BKBs. They have one up on 747.
Yeah, but Morphling really doesn't want to get a BKB.
You do not.
If you're forced to go BKB in a Morphling game, you're sad.
Or you're Chinese.
Yes.
Chinese love their BKB on Morphling.
And look at that. Takes the illusion.
Yep. Probably not what they had in mind as the Morphling pick, but this is why he's not good versus Edge.
Yeah, I would say this is a...
This is a shotgun and replicate back home. Mm-hmm. Replicate.
The draft is really starting to kick in for Shazam. And I would say Kingdom's window for taking control of the game has almost closed.
They can't take control, but they can still win the late game. I think that's what they're aiming for.
Yeah, I think that's their only option now.
I think they planned that early, though.
I don't know. I don't think so. I think they didn't... obviously, you don't plan for the game to turn around like that in that fight with that Darkseer wall vacuum.
That's true. Maybe...
Like, you don't want that to happen, obviously. I guess alright, guys, we're going to take control of the first 20 minutes, and then we're just going to give it away like that.
But versus Alchemist, you... Like, in your mindset, if they first pick Alchemist, you know that if you don't win by 25, it's going to go late. It's going to go 50.
Sure.
And... Ja, gonna be the sacrificial lamb over here. 747 looking to blink in the trees and possibly TP out, and he will be safe. But yeah, when you see the Alchemist first, you're like, okay, we're either excuse me, we're either going to win and take control of the map early, or we're going to take it late. TC gets EB. He still has the Aegis, so two-man vacuum wall. 747 does pop his BKB in time. TC's first life will fall. MSS, Blink stuns Zizzy. He does have Strength Morph on, but not that much armor left. Actually, he has 18 armor. I thought he was maybe with a little bit of spray.
In the end, that's actually not bad for Kingdom. They get an Aegis for free.
Good space.
And they're forced to use the wall, and Beastmaster is putting pressure on the top lane.
So split push them to death. They have the tools. They have a Blink split pushing Jenkins.
Yeah, they
as well
they
as serve. BOTs. Zizzy is TPing in on the top lane. He does not have Manta style, so not really able to get that much more on T3. I thought he was going to be a man.
Oh, here
going
we
for
go.
The shotgun on SVG, but SVG is mega farmed. Not your dream as the shotgun morph.
Yeah, they certainly can't take team fights now, so their only option.
747 gets hexed up after being scattered out by the illusion, and the Lincolns will be thrown on him. No damage yet to follow. TC looking to maybe get some. Wow, he has heart. Whew.
Yeah, he's big.
He is very big.
I'd say. So if this game does go really, really ultra late,
I think it's gonna go ultra late.
Who do you think takes it?
I think Shazam, because CK seems to be near impossible to deal with. Morphling right. Can't really cleave him down, can't really burst down the Chaos Knight with shotgun. Clardar is terrible at clearing illusions, and Alk will be Alk, but these heroes are just going to get stronger and stronger. Even the Ench, who can get pulled a scepter because she didn't go that build. I think that Shazam have a lot more space to grow, and the inherent lack of AoE on Kingdom's lineup may be their downfall.
Yeah, I agree. In the end, how is Kingdom going to deal with, like, five split CK illusions with heart?
They split push. I think that's their best bet. They have BOTs, too, and they have Hawk to TP on. And that's what they're going to do. Zizzy with the replicate, only 7 seconds left, doesn't really feel safe. And Shazam, 3 TPs back. They immediately want to bend this tower. See, they feel the pressure now. Tower's at 300 HP. They know they don't want to give up Rags and Kingdom. Plink is very smart, I must say. Zizzy going for the shotgun after 747 goes in with the stun. TC on the back lines, still yet to cast Phantasm. We see Aurora vacuum wall onto one. And a 4 second stun, but at the end of the day, one for one trade, Kingdom buy themselves a lot of space because Shazam all forced a TP to that top lane.
And that tower is getting much lower right now.
Very nice play by Kingdom. They're going into these fights because they know they can't win straight 5-on-5s. So they pressure Shazam. They're like controlling where Shazam's moving around the map, which is what I really like. If they had gotten that Roche, they probably would have been upper Rex at
yeah,
this point.
I agree. It's very smart of Kingdom to switch gears. I like that a lot.
Yeah, they're not brute forcing the Alchemist.
Good. I think around the panel we didn't have
TC farming while he's low and gets taken out. Unable to armlet toggle yet again. Magnetize being his demise. And even then we see Earth Spirit having a Midas. Go back to what you were saying.
Around the panel there was a lot of talk about how Kingdom wasn't doing the greatest before this match, or just the greatest coming into this tournament, but I really like the way they've played here. I really like their decision making, you know, minus that one disastrous fight in the Radiant Jungle.
Their strategy is certainly top tier in this game. There's no way they would be this close unless it took some exceptional leadership and decision making, and being only down by 7,500 gold after taking that 4-4-0 at Roche is incredible. Against an Alk. An Alk charging up his stun. Looks like Jenkins will get stunned up along with MSS Brax. Maybe looking to pursue Jenkins over here, but too close for comfort. Is they will retreat.
MSS has his Octarine now, though.
No. Zizzy's pushing out into the lanes. If you look at the lane equilibrium, it's always all on Shazam's side of the map, which is very atypical when you see an Alchemist with this sort of farm. Usually, it's always pushed into the Kingdom side, but he can't do it because of the threat of the Beastmaster and the Morphling. These two in particular are playing fantastically.
Yeah. I like the pairs that Kingdom travels in. I know that, you know, we can kill most heroes traveling in a certain pack. and they allow Morphling to take the farm in the other lanes.
I think it's item progression check time.
Sure. So we have the medallion on Jaw. I like that a lot. And Susie747 has his BKB up on the Slardar. Looks like he's going for... Is that a Desolator with the other Mithril? Oh no, that is a... Is that a Golner? Maelstrom?
It's Maelstrom.
Yeah.
Okay, so he knows...
Getting some AoE to deal with the Chaos Knight, I don't think it's... I think it's like a Band-Aid. Gonna do too much.
I think Mjolnir is actually really good versus their lineup, though. Especially if you have Isle Shell, like, constantly ticking on you. It's gonna proc super often.
Yeah, but you have to make sure that whoever he puts that... puts that buff on stays alive. Or...
Like Morphling? Morphling can stay alive. He has a lot of armor.
I think it's one of those things that sounds good on paper, but in practice...
I think if he gets AC, it'll be good. And he can just BKB run in and tank with Mjolnir, and he can do a lot of damage.
If they hit him. I think Shazam is not going to target the Morphling.
I mean, they don't have to target him, though. Even with Acid Spray. Like, Acid Spray will still tick on him.
Sure.
I think there's too many... Oh, Shazam... trying to defend this D2, but replicated out and a lot of damage on a tower that Shazam probably feel helpless defending. They don't really have a good way to kill this Morphling now that he has a Lincoln's. Maybe Lion can blink in with a mana drain into a Hex, but ideally you want a 4-step on the Lion. You want instant cast. So blink, Q, 4-step plus Hex, and then you can immediately disable the Morphling. That's what you want. Clever Manta play. Or just good positioning by the Morphling, or good awareness, can counter that. Shazam's stuck on their side of the map.
Yeah, Beastmaster picks up a Vlad's. They are getting ways to deal with the not the overwhelming, but the superior team fight of Shazam.
Mjolnir plus AC plus Vlad's, I think that's very good at dealing with the CK. That was my main issue when Kingdom was heading up to the late game, but I think they have gotten the items to shore that weakness in their lineup.
We'll see how it plays out in actual execution.
Shazam smoked up to the left side of the Roshan pit. BOT coming in. Newsham gets stunned up, but they don't actually know that he's over here. MSS desperately trying to get the stun, and he will get the stun off as Newsham is trying to boulder away. Roshan is up. Brax may pop in. Scouted it out. Is this team going to actually do it? A little boar scouts out Brax, and
all the while Ziz does take out that bottom tower.
Yeah, he's about to push his T3, and they have to do something about it. They could give up Roche, but I don't think that's going to be a good idea. Zizzy, 15 seconds left on his replicate. T3 getting mauled down by Zizzy, and are they even going to... Roche is at 80%! Zizzy gets text up, and do they have enough lockdown to keep him in place? 3 seconds left on the replicate. Zizzy looks like he's in no man's land and will end up falling for half damage on a T3. Still two heroes left inside the pit. Braxton TC, TP out. 747 goes in for a two-man stun, followed by a roar. Morphling buyback. TC does have his ultimate, but no mana to even cast anything. And looks like Kingdom, they do want to get out of here. Wow, what a sick EB on Jenkins. Almost got the Ghost plus TP out. And at the end of the day, it looks like Kingdom with the worst end for the trade, especially if they give up this road. Roche is at 75%, and I do not think that Kingdom want to give this up for free. Do not want to use the Morphling's buyback in vain, but Beastmaster, no buyback at the ready. Couldn't BOT that close if he could, because he's the one with the summons, and it looks like Kingdom will just be staring down.
Oh, and Jaw's going to go down as well. And that's charging up, looking for one more hero, but doesn't look like he's going
to
get it.
This is the Bane of Kingdom. The Roche.
Yeah.
Nice play by Lion to get the Hex onto the Morphling. That's what real... If he didn't get that, they replicate back, kill the heroes in the pit, probably get Roche.
Yeah. Agreed. Big play. Instead, Morph dies and has to buy back and doesn't get anything out of it. And that net worth graph took a sharp dip in the favor of Shazam.
So good strategy, not great execution.
And yeah.
But two both times at Roche, just not good execution by Kingdom, or perhaps great play by Shazam, playing around Kingdom want to do.
It is a lot easier for Shazam to play these fights than it is for Kingdom.
Yes.
Kingdom has to get a lot of stuns, different targets, and they have to coordinate.
TC has to press R.
Yeah, all the different spells. MSS, same thing. All he really has to do, press R, acid spray something in the general vicinity, and just run at heroes.
Does he really even have to press R? I feel like he doesn't even need to have to press R. He could just walk in.
He kind of has to press R.
Okay. It's not that easy.
He has to press the button.
Nice.
Reef, what a player.
And Kingdom trying to find some objectives after conceding the Roche, but I don't think they're going to get any. Necro 3 stolen up by Ench and will not be able to get a lot of damage on this T2.
Still, I'd say this game is still pretty even. Yeah,
it is, because Creep Equilibrium still on Shazam's side a lot of the time. They had the Aegis, can they actually put it to use? Chaos Knight big and bad with Midas in his inventory.
Mm-hmm. But the real danger is always still going to be that Morphling. But pushing all the lanes, there's a exposed Rax top, the tower bottom isn't very healthy either.
But kill Morphling game. He doesn't have buyback.
That's true.
This could be a game winner right here.
And it looks like Morph is going to go back. Morphlings, please spend your gold. You don't have buyback anyways.
What is the B-Fly?
Yeah.
B-B's safer.
It is. But it's... I feel like if you have to buy a BKB this game...
You play not to lose, though.
Yeah, it's a play not to lose. It's not a play to win.
Well, TC, with 4 Phantasm Illusions, slightly lucky proc there. Sierra Roar, 747, stunning up TC. Yushin rolling in, Magnetize spreading everywhere. MSS plus SVG mow down the Beastmaster. Yushin shortly to fall after Aegis Pot. 3-man vacuum wall. SVG is just impotencing everybody. Zizzy. Dead. That's pretty much game.
Yeah, that should be game. They win on the tankiest target with an Aegis. It's not how you want to start out the fight.
Nope. And TC looking up to clean up the trash. Jenkins with the buyback. That is 2 buyback. That is too many. Morphlings. Costly death at the T3 will likely cost them the game. And damn, just going for the finishing blow. Straight for the throne, Nushum being taken down behind his donation. And all 5 heroes of Shazam left alive. 1 buyback left on the Venge, who's about to respawn in 1 second anyways. And she is a lone survivor defending against this army of heroes. Killing T4s.
That is game.
That is
pretty
game.
Much nothing Kingdom can do about it. It was a valiant effort. I was impressed by their rotations early and their ability
too.
To take the fight to Shazam and then change gears.
However, the draft at the end of the day was superior for Shazam, easier to execute.
Better team fight.
More room for mistakes.
Absolutely.
And they played those Roche fights spectacularly well.
Mm-hmm.
Who would you say is MVP here? Or game? It could even be on Radiant.
I want to say it was Nushum, actually.
I think it was Nushum too.
He